Hello everyone, today we will be talking about chapter number 13 named as Why Do We Fall Ill? So before jumping to this question that why do we fall ill, let us see a few of the basic terms like health, disease, what they look like, how are they caused. Let us clear all these terms before. So our body has interconnected activities. What does this mean? So in our organs or tissues, there are various specialized activities going on. The heart is beating, the lungs are breathing, the kidney is filtering urine, the brain is thinking. All these activities are going on and these activities are interconnected. Now how do we say that these activities are interconnected? So let us see this with an example. If the kidney's function is to filter the urine, right? Filtering urine. And if kidneys are not filtering urine, they are not doing their function, what is going to happen? The poisonous substances will start accumulating, right? In the body. And in such conditions, the brain will not be able to think properly because of this poisonous substance accumulating in the body. Our brain functioning will be affected. So you can see, because of one organ not functioning properly, the activity of the other organ is getting affected, right? And that is the reason why we say that all the activities of the bodies are interconnected. So anything which is preventing the proper functioning of cells, tissues or organ, it will lead to lack of proper activity of body. It is ultimately going to affect the activity of whole body, right? So this is why we say that all the organs or all the activities of the body are interconnected, and if one is affected, the other is obviously going to get affected. Now we have heard the word health used quite frequently all around us, right? We use this word in our day-to-day life. We many times say things like my grandmother or my sister or relative is not feeling well, I'm not well, I'm unhealthy, right? Today my health is not well. Even many a times we say don't eat unhealthy foods. This food type is not healthy for us, right? Eat healthy food. Many a times we say that nowadays we are living in an unhealthy environment. The climatic, the environmental conditions are unhealthy for us. Then even our teachers or our parents always tells us that these habits are unhealthy habits for you. Change your habits, adapt some healthy habits, adapt some healthy attitude. So what does this health exactly means? It is used in terms of food also, it is used in terms of habit, it is used in terms of when you are not feeling well. What is it? Do all these conditions somehow contributes in the word health? So yes, it's correct. So health, what is health? So health is basically physical health, mental health and social health, right? So when I say that I am healthy, which means I am healthy in all these three terms, I am healthy physically, mentally as well as socially. Now if any of one health is affected, okay, right, for example, I am healthy physical and socially, but if my mental health is not proper, which means somehow ultimately gradually my social and physical health is also going to get affected, which means further, I won't remain healthy as healthy I am now, right? So when I say, or when anyone says that the person is healthy, it refers in terms of all these three health, physical, mental and social. It always doesn't mean that if you are physically healthy, it doesn't mean that you are mentally and socially healthy as well. Okay, so when we refer to health, we refer to health in these three terms, physical health, mental health and social health, and all these three terms are going to affect health of an organism. Okay, so health means a state of physical, mental, social well-being, right? But does it depend on an individual? Obviously not. Okay, When we talk about health of an organism, it depends on their surroundings or their environment. Okay, it's not something that you yourself, only yourself can maintain. Like for example, my physical and mental health is good, but my social health is not good. So somehow it is going to get affected. I am the one who is going to get affected out of it, right? So what does health means? Physical, mental and social well-being. And it doesn't depend on just an individual. It depends on the surroundings or the environment. Now over here, what environment refers to, it refers or it includes physical environment or social environment, right? Now, for example, if you think about that, where there is a cyclone, okay, so there is physical change in, like, there is change in our surrounding, and that is when our physical health can get affected, right? We can get hurt or something can happen, right? So health is at risk in cyclone, right? Or in any other natural calamities, right? So this is what we can say, that it is a example of a physical environment. Okay, now our social environment refers to, for example, if I am living in a village or if I am living in a town. So that is my social environment, that how people around me, how my surroundings are. And these surroundings are obviously going to get affect me, right? So like for example, if the one who comes to or who cleans your streets or who cleans your society, who cleans the drainage in your society, right? Or the garbage picker, okay? So the agencies which make sure that the garbage in your society is always disposed properly, collected properly. If all of these decide not to come and not to do their function, what is going to happen? Okay, what will happen if they don't do their responsibilities? So all the garbage and everything would be lying in the way, everywhere, in on the streets, in your societies, and slowly and gradually there would be mosquitoes, there would be flies on that garbage, it will start degrading on the street side, and all these things are directly going to get they are directly going to affect the public health, right? The people living in the surroundings, they are going to get affected because of their social environment, right? So social as well as physical environment plays an important role in our life when we talk about health, right? So I hope this is very much clear. Okay, now let us see, we are clear about health. Now let us see what does a disease means. So disease, it is a term which is made up of two words. One is dis and the other is ease. Okay, now this dis means disturbed or discomfort. Okay, it's something which is making us disturb. And ease means which is affecting our comfort. Okay, so the things or the condition in which we are not in our comfort, we are discomfort, or we are not in our ease, that condition is called as disease. Okay, so poor health always doesn't mean that we are diseased. Okay, now it always doesn't mean that I have some or the other disease, which means my health is poor, or for example, my health is poor, which means I'm diseased. Okay, they are two very much different things. Okay, let us see disease in more detail so that you will understand the difference between health and disease. Now, how do we know that there is a disease in our body? How can we identify that I have some or the other disease? So we know that there are different organs in our body, right? And these organs, they do a specific functions. All organs have their specific function. But when there is a disease in our body, either the functioning or the appearance of any system or any organs of the body is going to change. It is going to change in a way that it is going to make it worse. Okay, so this is how we are going to identify, okay, I am having one or the other disease. You cannot identify the particular disease, that which disease I am having, but at least you can know that I am having a disease, right? Because the functioning of that organ or the appearance of that organ or the system is not proper, right? Now, and these all changes, they are going to give rise to two things. That is symptoms and signs of the disease. Okay, so when I have disease, I can see symptoms and signs of it, which by which I can conclude that I have some disease, right? For example, let us see what these two terms mean. Symptoms means that when we feel as something being wrong in our body, like when you have fever, you feel very much discomfort, or you are uneasy, you are weak, your body temperature rises up, right? So this is something that is called as symptom, right? That you can see. Whereas when we talk about sign, it is something which physician looks for in our body depending on the symptoms. When you go to a doctor asks you what is happening, ye dukh raha hai, aankh batao, ye karo, wo karo. By all these things, he is going to conclude that which kind of disease you have and what should be its medication, right? So that is sign. Also, symptom, it doesn't indicate a particular disease. Obviously, I can have fever in malaria, I can have fever in typhoid, I can have fever in other things as well, right? So it is not necessary that if I have fever, I am definitely going to have malaria or I'm definitely going to have typhoid, right? It is just a symptom by which I cannot indicate the disease, but I can guess that what that disease can be. Whereas when I talk about science gives us a definite confirmation or a bit of indication of a particular disease being present in the body. So this was the difference between symptoms and signs, and I hope that difference between disease and health is also clear. Now let us talk about types of disease. Now there are two types of disease basically depending on the duration of disease in your body, right? So they are acute and chronic, okay? So this classification or this division is depending on the time duration of the disease in your body, right? So now acute disease, it is caused for a very short period of time. It doesn't leave for a longer time and it doesn't give you major effects on your body or on your health. Okay, so that type of disease is called as acute disease, where you don't have or you don't suffer for a longer period of time. Whereas when we talk about chronic disease, it is something which is going to cause for a longer period of time or else lifelong as well. And it can cause major effect on your body or on your health. Okay, like for example, if I have this diabetes, so diabetes is something which is going to I'm going to have it for lifelong maybe. So this was about chronic disease, which can gives us effect on our body or on our health for a longer period of time. Example, we can say for acute disease, we have common cold or viral fever, which doesn't gives us major effects on our body for a longer period of time, and it occurs for a very short period of time, and after proper medication it is no more in our body. But when we talk about chronic disease like tuberculosis, cancer, these kind of disease, they remain in a body for a longer period of time, and also they cause effect on they cause a major effect on our body, right? So this was about types of disease, and we will be seeing these types of disease in more detail in next video of this chapter. Till then, take care of yourself and keep reading. Thank you for watching the video.